Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you angle and solid angle in great details. Here, first of all, I'll be explaining you measurement of angle in form of radian. After that, I'll explain you measurement of solid angle in form of steradian. And at last, I'll explain you relation of angle and solid angle. So let us start this video with first agenda, that is measurement of angle in form of radian. See, angle in form of radian is two dimensional angle. Like if you have two lines and in between these two lines, if you want to measure angle in form of radian, then that will be arc length divided by radius. So two dimensional angle is angle in form of radian. So here for circle, if I say radius is r, then you can measure angle in between two points on circle. If I say here we have point A, here if I say we have point B, then angle in between point A and point B, that can be measured by arc length in between A and B divided by radius r, right? So here angle is theta in form of radian, that will be arc length AB divided by radius. If I say arc length AB, that is L and radius is r, then L by r, that is angle in form of radian, right? Now, if you want to calculate angle for complete circle, then for complete circle, what is arc length? For complete circle, arc length, that will be 2 pi r, right? So, for complete circle, arc length is 2 pi r. In that case, for complete circle, angle will be how much? For complete circle, angle theta will be 2 pi r divided by radius r, means it will be 2 pi radian. So 2 pi radian, that is angle of complete circle, right? Now I'll explain you solid angle. See, solid angle is three dimensional angle. Solid angle is three dimensional angle, and that we measure in form of steradian. Now question is how to identify solid angle. So here we have a sphere. See, circle is there in two dimension, right? But when you want to calculate solid angle, at that time you need to have three dimensional structure. So here I am considering sphere as a three dimensional structure. So with this sphere, if I say radius is r, with this sphere, if I say radius is r, and on this sphere, let us assume we have area A. With this sphere, let us assume area is A. Then three dimensional angle is solid angle. So here we have three dimensional angle, that is solid angle, and that can be calculated as per area divided by square of the radius, right? So solid angle, that is calculated in form of steradian, and that will be how much? Area divided by radius square. If I say area is A and radius is small r, then A divided by r square, that is solid angle in form of steradian, right? As if you want to calculate solid angle for complete sphere, then for complete sphere, one should know the area. For complete sphere, area is 4 pi r square. So for complete sphere, solid angle is how much? Solid angle in form of steradian will be this area, that is 4 pi r square divided by radius square, right? So here this radius square, that is getting cancelled, and we will be having 4 pi steradian, that is solid angle for complete sphere, right? So for complete sphere, solid angle is 4 pi. While for complete circle, angle is 2 pi. And that angle is there in form of radian. And in solid angle, we have unit of steradian. Right. Now, I'll explain you relation in between angle and solid angle. See, angle is measured in two dimensions. And solid angle is measured in three dimensions. Right. Like you can observe here, you see, if you talk about 1 radian, then for 1 radian, arc length will be r and radius will be r. In that case, you can have angle in form of radian is equals to 1 radian. How? Arc length divided by radius, that is angle. So here arc length is r and radius is r. So angle will be 1 radian over here. In solid angle calculation, here we will be considering area. So as if area is r square and here radius is r. So in that case, solid angle is area divided by r square. So r square is getting cancelled and we can have solid angle that is 1 steradian, right? So if you want to measure 1 steradian in form of angle in terms of radian, then it will be how much? It will be 1 steradian is equals to 1 radian into 1 radian. Why? The reason is here you see, if you talk about square, in that case, one dimensional angle that is having 1 radian into another dimension 1 radian will be resulting into 1 steradian, right? So if you want to calculate steradian in form of radian, then 1 steradian is equals to 1 radian into 1 radian. So you can say it is 1 radian square, right? Sometimes you may need to calculate this 1 steradian in form of degree square. So here one should know 1 radian is equals to how much degree? It will be 180 by pi, right? So here 180 by pi square, that is there in form of degree square. And 1 steradian, that is equals to how much degree square? So 180 by pi whole square, that much amount of degree square will be there. Let me see what is my answer. That is 3286.13 degree square, right? So 1 steradian in form of degree square, that is 3286.13, right? Now if you want to calculate solid angle for complete sphere, like you see, for complete sphere, I have explained you solid angle, that is 4 pi steradian, right? So for complete sphere, solid angle is 4 pi steradian. And if you want to calculate this solid angle in form of degree square, then it will be 4 pi into 3286.13 degree square. And if you solve this, you will be getting 41273.88 degree square, right? So that is how one can calculate solid angle in form of degree square, right? And see, 1 steradian, that is equals to 1 radian square, that is also the basic unit of steradian in form of radian, right? Now one more thing that I would like to explain you. See, here we calculate solid angle in form of 3D angle, right? So how to identify it? So if you want to calculate that by integration, then see, if you want to calculate solid angle, then you will have to do integration by dimensions, where see here we have two different angles variation. One is varying with respect to theta and second is varying with respect to phi, right? So here, if you want to have that calculation, then here one angle is varying with respect to theta, second angle is varying with respect to phi, and here this d rho, that will be sine theta d phi. That is how by having integration, one can calculate angle in form of steradian, right? So as and when you want to calculate steradian at that time, before you apply limits, you will have to apply sin theta d theta d phi, where theta is varying from one limit to another limit, and phi is also varying from one limit to another limit, and you will have to calculate solid angle, right? I hope now you are having fair enough idea about how we can apply limits and what is the basic relation in between angle and solid angle. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.